We have all cried, sometimes tears of hurt, tears of pain, tears of joy, tears of loss, tears of sorrow.
I lost my job, my home, everything!
But how many of you have cried tears of sorry? So sorry that you wish you could change what happened and even change yourself so it doesn't happen again. Today, we're going to explore the second beatitude.
Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted.
Wait a second. Happy are the unhappy? Those who are mourning are anything but happy.
But what if you finally realize that you're going down the wrong way, and then finally choose to follow the directions and you turn towards the right way?
When you see that your eye wants and your eye of pride are driving you down the wrong way road and make a U-turn back to God's way, you just made a right move to eternal happiness. So to really understand the second beatitude, we need to look back to the first beatitude.
First, you have to realize that you are poor in spirit and you need God. And the second is mourning over your sin and being comforted and forgiven by our amazing God, who is also mourning over your sin because He loves you and He doesn't want you to be lost.
You can only mourn or cry when you care. God cares about us. When we care about the things that God cares about, we're sad when He's sad. It helps us get closer to Him. And God comforts us. Comfort in Greek means to come alongside you. And when He does, He binds up your broken heart with His love and forgiveness and gives you encouragement and strength through His word.
King David said that the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and He rescues those who are crushed in spirit. Even his son King Solomon said, "Sorrow is better than laughter, for by sadness of the face the heart is made glad."
But how?
When we're sad, it feels like our hearts are broken or crushed. Like a crushed vase, we don't know if we'll ever feel whole again. In Japanese art, they fill those broken pieces together with gold, and the broken places then become the strongest parts. Even though God sees our flaws and failures, He makes us stronger than we were when we offer our tears of sorry and give Him all the pieces of our heart. As He puts the pieces together, others can see God's light shine through you in those broken places, and you will be able to come alongside them and give them the comfort that God gave you.
When we are crushed and cry for our wrong ways, God revives our heart and fills us with the Holy Spirit. And through those broken places of our heart, God shines through. And others are drawn to that light so they could be comforted too.
But it's a dangerous road for those who didn't say sorry for their sin, or even think they did anything wrong. They are blind, holding on to the I want and the I of pride, and don't see the wrong way road. They are also blind to God's forgiveness and deaf to His comfort.
But how can God wipe away the tears that you haven't wept?
One day the Pharisees asked Jesus to eat with them, and He went to the Pharisees' house and sat down to eat. Suddenly, a woman in the city, who was a sinner, found out that Jesus sat at the table at the Pharisee's house and brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil. Standing at His feet behind Him, weeping, she began to wash His feet with her tears and wipe them with the hair of her head. She kissed His feet and anointed them with the fragrant oil. The Pharisee Simon thought he never did anything wrong. He didn't love Jesus and definitely didn't want His forgiveness because he thought he didn't do anything wrong. He thought everyone saw him as a good man, even God. The woman, though, on the other hand, could only think of her sinfulness and her great need for forgiveness. That made her mournfully weep and love the one who could forgive and love her no matter what. Jesus said, "Therefore I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love is shown. But whoever has been forgiven little, loves little." She was forgiven and played a major role in spreading the good news of Christ's resurrection.
Nothing shuts us off from God more than pride. The more clearly we see our wrong ways, the better person we are. The worst sin is to think you have no sin. Jesus mourned and cried over Israel because they thought they had no sin. How could they come to God to be comforted with His forgiveness if they thought they didn't do anything wrong?
After riding on a colt, everyone proclaimed, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." He approached Jerusalem and saw the city and wept over it. If you, even you, had only known on this day what would bring you peace, but it's now hidden from your hearts. How often I long to gather your children together, as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but you were unwilling. The days will come upon you when your enemies will build a wall against you and encircle you. They will dash you to the ground and they will not leave one stone on another. All because they didn't recognize that Jesus was their savior from sin.
Can you imagine waving a wrong way sign to protect people from getting hurt, but no one paid attention to you? Wait a second, are you paying attention to me? That's how Jesus feels when you don't pay attention to him. Jesus is trying to communicate to you the same way that your body communicates to you. You feel pain when you're doing something wrong.
If you touch a hot stove, your brain and body sends the message to you that it's hot, so you immediately stop touching it and probably cry from the pain, otherwise you'd be in big trouble. God allows tears and pain to tell you to stop so you don't hurt yourself more and protects you from harm. You are not really sorry until you're sorry enough to stop. The Pharisees were like a hardened piece of Play-Doh, whose hearts could no longer be changed. They were insensitive to the heat and would not let Jesus' light shine through. In their darkness, they could no longer see their wrong ways and didn't even think they were going the wrong way, and definitely did not stop.
Because Israel did not stop going the wrong way road, they were destroyed. They died like a fruitless fig tree because the soil of their heart was hard. They were not forgiven for following their eye of pride and I once, instead of crying tears of sorrow for their sin.
On the wrong way road, just like a piece of hardened Play-Doh, the soil is hard and nothing can grow on it. But when we connect to Jesus by bending our knees to the ground in prayer and letting the tears of sorrow for being sorry water the soil of our heart, it grows the seed of God's word and molds and shapes us to look more like Jesus, forgiving others, comforting them the way that God has comforted you in your sins through His words and His presence, and shining the fruit of His Spirit as you look towards the Son of God.
You can't grow or go the right way until you realize you're not. One day Jesus appeared to Paul, shining more radiantly than the sun, to stop him from going the wrong way road, and told him to go to Straight Street to grow good fruit. Let's see if he listened.
Saul was threatening to imprison and destroy the Lord's disciples. He even went to the high priest and requested letters of permission from him to deliver to the synagogues of Damascus, saying if he found anyone who belonged to the Way, which was the name for early Christians, he would bring them as prisoners back to Jerusalem. As he was going to Damascus, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" So he said, "Who are you, Lord?" He replied, "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting." Although Saul's eyes were open, he couldn't see anything. Jesus said, "Get up and go to the street called Straight, and there you will be told what to do." For 3 days he could not see, and he could neither eat or drink. After Paul went to Straight Street, he finally walked the right road, and he was baptized. He mourned later, confessing, "I do not understand what I'm doing. What I want to do, I don't do, and what I hate doing, I do. The good I want to do, I don't do, and the evil I don't want to do, I do. Oh, wretched, miserable man that I am, who will rescue me?" But then he thanked God for his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, for rescuing him. When we are tuned into God's Word and spend time with Him, we will mourn, realizing we've been going down the wrong road. But He will lead us on the straight street as we follow the light of His directions. One day Hilkiah the high priest found the book of the law in the house of the Lord, and they read it to King Josiah. When the king heard the words of the book of the law, he mourned when he realized they were going the wrong way. He even tore his clothes, which was a sign of mourning. He said, "For great is the wrath of the Lord that burns against us, because our fathers have not obeyed the words of this book by doing all that is written." Then the king called together all the elders of Judah and Jerusalem. The king stood by his pillar and renewed the covenant in the presence of the Lord, to follow the Lord and to keep his commands, statutes, and decrees with all their heart and all their soul, and to obey the words of the covenant written in God's book. Josiah removed all the detestable idols from all of the territory belonging to the Israelites, and he had all those who were present in Israel to serve the Lord their God. As long as he lived, they did not fail to follow the Lord, the God of their ancestors. Some people just smile and are prideful of driving on the wrong way road and don't feel sorry at all, let alone mourning and grieving over their wrong ways. Sin, though, is a serious business, and it ultimately is responsible for all the pain, disease, and death, including our own and our Savior's. He actually died of a broken heart, not because of crucifixion. That's why he knows how to comfort the brokenhearted and the crushed in spirit. Comfort is an old English word containing the same root as the word fortify, like you would find in the word fortress, which protects those who are inside and makes them strong. Jesus said that the one who is mourning will also be the one who is made strong. In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus was deeply mourning, knowing that he would be paying for the sins that would separate him from his Father. He mourned so deeply that blood burst forth from his forehead. And it says that even as he was agonizing in prayer, an angel came, comforted, sustained, and fortified him. He went through it all just to help you now and to be with you forever because he loves you.
When you truly mourn and cry over your sins, not because you got caught, but you're crying tears of sorry, it directs you back to God. No wonder Jesus said, "Blessed are those who mourn." It's a blessing to have him walk beside you, to comfort you with his words, to save you with his forgiveness, to carry you home and open the door to eternal life. Now that's a blessing you don't want to miss. Bible treasure hunt time!
It's time to get your Bibles out for the clue came true. Our first clue comes from Ezra 7:10, and it came true in John 1:14. Jesus is the made flesh and has the power to change our hearts. Our next clue comes from Nehemiah 2:17, and it came true in John 2:19. Jesus, what is dead and broken. Our final clue comes from Esther 2:20-21, and it came true in Mark 9:30-31. Our King Jesus told his that he would be.
No one can take your place, and there is no other. Forever yours and yours alone. Now I'm in a secret place, alone in your embrace, where all my wrongs have been erased. You have forgiven all the promises and lies, all the times I compromised, all the times you were denied. You have forgiven. Oh, 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 oh. Alone in your embrace, where all my wrongs have been erased. You have forgiven all the promises and lies, all the times I compromised, all the times you were denied. You have forgiven. Oh, 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 oh.
Remember, the tears that you shed will bring the blooms of joy. May God guide you and protect you wherever you go. God bless.